Welcome to Face Islam, the program dealing with the subject of the difficulties that Muslims everywhere are facing on a daily basis. And in today's program, I want to start out by talking about a word, shirk. In Arabic language, this is a very serious word, if not maybe one of the most serious words in the Arabic language for Muslims, because it is the unforgivable blasphemy, the worst sin that a person could even invent. In chapter 4 of the Quran, verse 48, Allah tells us clearly that He does not forgive shirk. But anything else, He says, He can forgive. But whoever is coming up with shirk, then this is something, a monstrous sin. What is it, though? And if you go to your Bible and look in Exodus chapter 20, you're going to find something that explains it in good details, because it's the same God who revealed that Bible, the same God that gave the message to Adam, Abraham, Moses, David, Suleiman, Jesus Christ, and Muhammad. Peace and blessings be upon them all. And what does it say in Exodus 20? You'll find it in Deuteronomy, but let's go with this one as well. It's talking about one God, worshiping Him without any partners. I'm the Lord your God that brought you out of the land of Egypt, the house of bondage. You know no other God beside me. Beside me there's no other God. Thou shalt not have any other gods beside me. Is that clear? I'm sorry, but that sounds pretty clear to me. And as far as when people start talking about a Trinity or having more than one God, and that it's all the same God at the same time, it's also very clear in the New Testament. When we look there, we find it says it in Mark 12:29, when they're talking to Jesus about the greatest commandment. Look what he said. The greatest commandment is to know, O Israel, the Lord your God is one Lord. So if anybody had an idea about three, that sure canceled that out. Along with that, whenever somebody is committing this, what they're basically doing is canceling everything and anything else they did for God. Let me give you a little bit of insight onto that one. Suppose somebody is worshiping Jesus, and he didn't tell him to do that. Suppose somebody's worshiping Moses, and he didn't tell him to do that. Suppose somebody is worshiping Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he also forbid that. Now, these people could be believing that by worshiping that individual that came with the message of God, that somehow that's the same as God. Well, that's major shirk. Shirk al-Akbar. Shirk al-Akbar. The greatest shirk is to worship something other than God. Denying God and believing in some ideologies and fantasies, theories that people have come up with, and then just as quick come up with something else when it didn't work, is the same thing in front of Allah. Because to deny Him when it's clear that all this universe did not come out of emptiness, it had to start somewhere. And this universe deteriorates, doesn't it? So how did it come about to start with? If you said, well, it just blew up and then it became improved, then that's against logic, because everything we see actually deteriorates, doesn't it? It doesn't increase in quality. And as far as evolution is concerned, well, same problem. Because evidence shows that there were large creatures, very large creatures, that they didn't evolve up into something, they disappeared. And now we have smaller creatures. So that didn't work. And all of the monkeys that we see today, that supposedly are the forerunners of the human beings, They still exist. So that also becomes, in front of Allah, another form of shirk. To deny Allah, to worship other than Allah, to believe in something having power other than Allah. All of this is unforgivable in front of Allah. But by the way, how do we treat somebody who's not a Muslim and doesn't want to believe? Do you know it says in the Quran, La ikraha fi din. We cannot force anyone to believe. We are only to deliver a message. Tell the people, just like we're doing right now, that if you really want to know about Allah, ask Him to guide you. If there is a God, then it would be up to Him to do that. By the way, He did it to me. He guided me from those words, O God, guide me. Yeah. And guide us, every day we say, guide us away from this shirk and guide us toward Iman, which is the correct faith. All of that comes together whenever we ask Him for this guidance. And certainly we want to remember that any kind of shirk is something that will put a person in the hellfire forever. May Allah save us from that. And that's Face Islam.